Hey everyone, it's Lauren here. Well, have I got a story to share with you. Firstly, here is the completed layout I have created for the Hip Kit Club. I was challenged by the team to create a layout using a mixed media background and using a white cut file, and I chose this one here, which says you are amazing, which is one of the January free cut files. And yeah, so this is what I've created. So I've got a big apology to make. As you can probably hear in my voice, I'm not really happy. I'm laughing, but I'm not happy. My wonderful computer system crashed, and I lost 3/4 of the process video that I had edited for this, to share with you how I put this together as part of my requirements for the design team. And it crashed, and I only got about 10 minutes of footage of the process, which I will share with you at the end of when I finish talking here, so you can see how I put together my background, which I think for a lot of you, people really comment and say that they love my mixed media backgrounds and how I use the magicals. So at least that little bit of the footage that I did keep is about me sharing how I put this background together, which I'll talk to you about. So after I realised this, I had a minor anxiety attack, I guess you could say, and I really just had to, because I don't like disappointing people at all. I like to, when I commit to something, I really like to make sure that I do it well. And so this really threw me, but then I had to step back and make a coffee and just say, okay, Lauren, what are we going to do? We're going to share that little bit of footage, which I will at the end. That'll show you how some of the technique I used to put this background together. And I'm just going to talk about how I put this layout together. And I think that's the best I can do. And I really hope that you guys still enjoy this video, even though it's not my usual style. But here you have it. Here is the layout I created, and I absolutely loved this cut file. It's fun, the scripty font is gorgeous, and I knew it was a perfect cut file to match this delightful photo of my daughter and her girlfriends at her birthday party. So I thought I'll just share with you how I put this layout together. A couple of interesting things happened when I put this layout together. I used my usual clear gesso on my white cardstock, which is the Basil Marshmallow. And I was right at the end of a bottle, like I was scraping the barrel of a bottle of gesso. And so it ended up being applied quite thick, and I actually was, when I was doing it, I actually thought, oh, this is actually really thick and good. I'm going to be able to really put a lot of water onto this page and really get these magicals going. And but what happened was, which was a really interesting effect, is that the magicals resisted some of the areas. So you'll see when I'm doing the little bit at the end, if you want to hang around and see how this background sort of came together, you'll see that some of the magicals really resisted. So I did a lot of drying off between layers, that kind of technique, to really be able to apply more medium on top to make sure my background was completely covered. And the reason why I really wanted that solid base but multiple colours across the base is because I really wanted this white cut file to stand out. And if there was white patches around, that I would lose the cut file into the background. And already, even though this background's quite busy, there is a sense of kind of losing that cut file anyway. So the things that I sort of did to sort of bring that cut file to life was, I used foam tape to mount it, and as you can see, I've been a bit lazy and sort of just you know, pop these little foam squares around, but some of them stand out. So if you're really particular about things standing out, just make sure your foam is well hidden there. I'm not too worried about that. I think it looks fine. And I use these So Frosty exclusive vellum. Oops, sorry, wrong packet. I put them in the wrong packet. Vellum stars to put behind key points of the cup file to make them stand out. So as you can see, the navy has really made that section pop. The yellow has really made that A kind of jump off. So you can really see that amazing sort of starting off, and this star here, and just these stars around just to help it kind of jump off the page. So that's the other sort of technique that I've used there, just to help that cut file. These vellum stars are absolutely delightful. You've got lots, here they are, lots in the packet, and I've still got more there which I'll use, but it just sort of really helped make this sort of this layout come together and add those embellishments that won't take away from the photo but still help the layout kind of come together, if that makes sense. I've just used a wet glue and just put a small dot behind each of the centers of the vellum stars. So sometimes when vellum dries, they curl up a little bit, which is a nice little effect and can sort of help bring a layout to life as well with a bit of dimension. The wet glue that I use is this one here, which is a Tombow mono liquid glue. I find that really good. It's got two tips, but I find that I only end up using the fine tip. So I really love this glue, and whenever I can find it, I usually grab a number of bottles there. So the magicals on the background I've used are all out of the December kits, which here they are. We've got Andrea's Azalea, Jana's Jade, and Martina's Marigold. I always mark down on the tops of my magicals and my colour kits what month kit they came out of, because before you know it, you end up with a huge bucket full and you can't remember what kits came with what and things like that. So that just helps me reminds me, and also when I'm doing videos and voiceovers, it lets me tell you what kits they came out of, if that interests you, to pop over to the Hip Kit Club and purchase one. So the other thing that I did to help this cut file and these stars sort of come to life was use these gorgeous Prima Spring Farmhouse crystals. There's 48 pieces in the set, and they're absolutely gorgeous and sparkly, if you can see that through the plastic there. So I've just added those at random spots around the layout, just to sort of bring to life a little bit more and add a little bit of dimension. The other thing that I've used are the gorgeous So Frosty flares. These are exclusive ones, and I think I've talked about this before. If you watch my videos, I struggle with flares at times. Sometimes just the bulk on them, I tend to shy away of, and I think that's when my layouts are predominantly flat without too much dimension. But I knew that when I was foaming these things up and I had my background really creating a depth, and I had this cluster around my photo here, that I possibly could add a little bit more dimension to it, which would help come to life. So I took advantage of that and applied three gorgeous little flares there. This one says "So Very Chilly," and I knew that wouldn't apply to my photo, so I just put "So Very," and it says "You are amazing, So Very." I thought that kind of worked. This gorgeous little flower one here, and the other one I've just tucked in there as well. So I thought I'm really going to maximize my opportunity to add some flares to my layout when I knew that it was going to be quite a dimensional one, and I use those three there, which are just delightful. The other thing that I really want to do is to help my layout, well, my photo, which in a sense they are full frame photos, but there's so many little girls, and it ends up being quite busy, you know. And so I didn't want to lose, in my busy background, I didn't want to lose my, the, you know, I'm getting my words muddled up. I didn't want to take away from the photo. So to help the photo, I did lots of layers behind my photo, and I even added some extras out the top there just to create a little bit of an interest effect. And sometimes I do that because I'm really not sure what I'm going to put up there. Sometimes I might put a word up there or some tabs. So just by adding a few layers at the top or the bottom or even both, sometimes that really works well and gives me points where I can add embellishments. I didn't put it on the bottom because I knew my title was going there, and I wanted to make sure that I could really I wanted to make sure my background wasn't covered up too much so my cut file would really stand out. So I did lots and lots of layers, as you can see just in there, and I just used some off cuts of some pattern paper that came in the December kits, and these couple of layers were some of the Project Life, Pocket Life cards. And I just laid them up. They're beautiful and thick, so it allows you, when you kind of want to ruffle your edges and do it with a blade or something, an edge distressor. This is the edge distressor that I use, and it's got that blade right there, and I just sort of scrape that along. It allows you to get a bit vigorous because the cardstock is really thick. So that's how I sort of really wanted to pop my photo off the page and not let it get lost in the background, and that's how I've achieved that with that one there. And then I just thought, I just wanted some little bit of interest points and little bits of detail around the layout, so I couldn't go past these absolutely delightful Pretty Little Studio cold out mini alphabet stickers. This is from their Glitter and Ice collection, and down here they had lots of little just random words, and most of those random words were applicable to my photo, so I got to apply those. And then I just used an X and an O just to make a kiss and a cuddle. So here is where I've used those here, and I've just sort of done a little concertina down there just to make them a little bit off center and always lovely. Over here, there's my kiss and cuddle. Can't get enough twinkle lights, so true, and cuddle and dream. So I've just added those around, which just make it a little bit special, and there's my layout. So I'm so sorry this is not a process video. I was really upset, and I hope that you guys aren't upset. The beautiful Joanne from our Hit Kit Club family over in our Facebook group she even commented when I put my sneak peek up, because at that point everything was going smooth sailing and I thought I just had to do my voiceover. And she commented that she really likes watching my video. So a big sorry to you, Joanne, that this is not a process video, but I hope this sort of explains the layout, and I'll put the little bit of footage I've got of me making my background up next, so you guys can watch that if you want to have a closer look how I did that. So here you go. I hope you like it. I hope it's inspired you to get out your mixed media products and use a white cut file on top, and keep scrapping, and most importantly, take care. Bye.